So guys, can someone tell me what happened today? You think Canadians want to change?
Yeah!
I don't even know what the number is. Is it at least a majority? Our people are getting bigger and bigger. I'm just absolutely overwhelmed today. So if I'm not following the script properly, you have to forgive me. I want to first of all start by thanking this woman here. I have said a lot about her in the past, but as you know, she's my rock, and she's been incredible. And I just want to take this opportunity to just thank her and just tell her how much this journey has been with her. Of course, these two kids who's really passed, way past their bedtime, are here, and I want to really tell you there's a lot of time I need to spend with them. I've taken a lot of time out of their precious time in the last 2 years, so guys, we need to make up in the next year or so, maybe the next 4 years, okay? I want to thank my mother. I know my mother's not, doesn't usually come out much, but my mother is there. She is my moral compass, and she has guided me in such an incredibly, in all the right ways. Thank you doesn't even start to describe it. My mother-in-law's here. She's right here. And of course, my late father-in-law, many of you know him, and I'm sure he's towering over us tonight. This campaign had over 850 volunteers on our database. Make sure that they come out and help us today and this weekend. And to be honest, it took me weeks and weeks and weeks, and I still couldn't get through. So I apologize for those I haven't called, but I know you're all here today, so I want to thank you for that. You know, as volunteers, as people who've been in this journey for 2 years, and many of you have done many, many hours with us, we've seen every season this country has to offer. We've seen every street this virtually every street in Rouge Park. We've knocked on virtually every door. We've met tens and thousands of Canadians, and the youngest volunteer we had is 3 months old. And she's five. She's 5 months old now. I think our oldest volunteer is just past 80. So in between, we've had an incredible range of volunteers. So this campaign is about volunteers and the incredible work that all of you here have done. So thank you for that. And in the next few months and years, I will take the time to thank each one of you personally for what you've done. I want to thank my core staff at the office. Olivia, where are you? Woo! Nivet? Bran? So Bran's had to really put up with a lot of my things. So Bran, Jenny, Darny. You guys are amazing. It's an incredible team. It's what we call an A-team. I want to thank my core advisors, Asma Bala, Zubair Patel, First Kuna Maglingam. Mangalan, Brunanidhi, Arnold Chan, John Delacorte. They've been incredible. They've given us timely advice along the way, so we're really grateful for that. I want to thank the Writing Association and the entire executive. Please put up your hand. The members of the Writing Association, thank you. Thank you for doing this. Our E-Day Chair, Sloane Warch. You need to put your hand up. I can't see anybody. Oh, there she is, Sloane. Thank you. our E-Day coordinators, Raj Tarandasingham and Dan Thurajan. The execution today was incredible. The execution during the advanced polls, I think, was unprecedented. We had over 11,000 people who voted, and that's thanks to the work of this team. My legal team, you know, you would expect a lawyer to have a legal team, so I have probably the best team in the country. My legal team led by Dinesh Ramanani. Dinesh? Dinesh, thank you. And the team, great work today. I know we anything that even before it remotely came up, Dinesh had a memo and he was ready to go. So great work, guys. My campaign director, Omar Raza. Omar, there. Come on up, Omar.
Come on up, man.
Omar is a great friend. He drove this campaign strategically. I think we're very proud of the achievement, and a lot of the credit goes to the head. And Omar, thank you for what you've done today and the results as we see it. My CFO, Sassy, who made sure that we had enough money for this party tonight. There's some individual names I know I shouldn't go into, but I cannot go without acknowledging. I want to thank and acknowledge Sajivan, who has taken bullets on this campaign, and my friend, you've been an incredible friend, so thank you. Ikuriaya, can someone take a picture of him, please? He has documented every single one of our events from the beginning, so thank you. There's a lot of media who have been extremely generous, and they've been continuously supporting us. I want to thank the media for the great work. I don't want to name them, but you're all here today, so thank you. And again, I will personally thank you in the near future. I want to thank all the home centers, the homemade food that people brought in, the drivers, the people who came to put the stickers on, and the task never stops. Like, just, it's incredible, incredible what people have done. So I want to thank all the volunteers who've done the work. I am so indebted to Dave and Marlene, who are surrogate parents, who basically, from the beginning, made sure we had a very smooth campaign. Where are they? Come on up. And they actually did a lot of work tonight, so thank you both for what you've done. I'm trying to avoid the next person because I know I will get emotional when I talk about him. There's a young man you would have seen in the campaign who has, when I introduce him, oftentimes people ask me if he's my son. Oftentimes people have really been very impressed by what he has done. This campaign, this federal election was about age and experience. And I think youth come today. And the other reason the youth come today is because we have incredible youth like Mr. Gautam and Gurusam. Yeah. words really don't describe what he's done. This February, I was looking for a campaign manager, and you know, my last campaign manager actually went on to win another election today. Another youth. He ran Arnold Chan's campaign, and then I think Arnold probably did it in the 80s today. That's the youth that we're developing. So I was looking for a campaign manager, and I had to find someone. So I did an international search, literally, and came back to 3 blocks from where my office was. So I called up Delvin and said, "Delvin, we should meet and have dinner."
Worst decision.
A good job, and then I realized it's not just him that's crazy, it's the whole family that's crazy, because they're actually letting him do this.
Yeah.
And today this is the result, guys, so thank you. So anyway, you're going to see interruptions like this, but I'll keep it brief. I want to get into the final person I want to thank is the people at the Scarborough Convention Center who have been very cooperative and generous. I want to start by thanking the outgoing representatives of this riding. This area was served by 3 MPs, one from each political party. I want to thank John McKay, who has been an incredible friend and a mentor, and he supported us, and a great liberal. He got re-elected tonight in Scarborough Billboard. I want to acknowledge Cornelia Chizu, the MP, former MP for Pickering Scarborough East. And I want to especially thank the outgoing MP, Radhika Sitsabasin, from Scarborough, New Zealand. I would like to take this opportunity to thank the local candidates, Leslie Lewis from the Conservative Party, K.M. Chandikmar from the New Democratic Party, and Calvin Winter from the Green Party, and the entire team and families for stepping forward in Karani's election. While we have disagreed on so many different issues, it's very clear, and there's no doubt in my mind, that they meant well for this country, and I wish all of them well in the future. It goes without saying that I want to dedicate tonight and this victory to our young people and to the youth of Scarborough Park, and to this country. I've often heard people say that young people don't want to get involved in politics, that young people can't be bothered to vote. Well, let me tell you something today. And all of you in this room know, you know it because you've come here many, many times, that young people don't want to be involved in politics because it is seen as dirty, messy, and negative. We've seen the worst of this type of negativity in this riding and in this country. And my friends today, the people of Scarborough Rouge Park, and the people of Canada voted for real change, real positive change. Canadians from coast to coast to coast rejected again negativity, divisiveness, wedge politics, and voted for a new generation of leaders who will make Canada proud again. We will work with all levels of government, as Justin Trudeau as Prime Minister, and we will restore evidence-based decision-making. We will provide more money for middle class, and we'll build infrastructure, and we will rebuild our democracy. When I first had the opportunity to meet Justin Trudeau and had a long conversation with him, we had a very, very candid conversation about the concept of rights. And Justin said to me, if the 20th century was about defining rights, the 21st century is about giving life to those rights. Woo! And my friends, please be assured that going forward from today, I will work day and night to ensure that the rights of people in this land and across the country and around the world. Today you have given me and 337 other colleagues in Parliament a great responsibility and an honor. It's an honor that I cannot put into words, and equally it's a responsibility that I take to heart. And I promise you that I will not let you down. To the amazing people of Scarborough Rouge Park, thank you. I will ensure that your voice is heard, not just in Parliament, but also around the world to defend human rights and freedoms. My friends, today we have reaffirmed that better is